Greetings, Guardians. My name is Bife here. So I was just sitting around, getting a video ready, having a quiet day on Destiny, when OH MY GOD, OSIRIS! Ah! Yeah, okay, it happened. It really did happen. Paris Games Week, we have a trailer for Curse of Osiris. Ah, wow, so, let's just jump in and talk thoughts. A few things that I want to point out in this trailer, but before we start any of that, note, yeah, I'm gonna have a full lore video on Osiris and everything we know about them, because, yeah, lots of story needs to be summarized on Osiris. He is, as the trailer keeps on putting out, one of the most famous guardians in all of Destiny, so there is a lot to cover. So, yeah, we'll get to that, but for the moment, let's talk about Osiris in the trailer. First of all, yes, Osiris is on Mercury, although that kind of simplifies it a little bit too much, because Osiris may still be stuck in the Vex Gate system, and if he is, then we're probably gonna have to do all sorts of interesting shenanigans to go and rescue him. Think time travel, think all sorts of things. It's... Yeah, there's tons that it could potentially be. Moving on further from that, though, there's a few other things that can be noticed in this trailer. Not only do you see some new guns there, we see some old returning exotics, and some new ones altogether. For starters, take a look at Osiris's gauntlets. They look like Sunbreakers, or perhaps like the old Nothing Manacles. Regardless, it looks like these are a white version now. I wonder whether this has a special perk versus the Vex, or whether this is something made to improve Dawnblade. It does look like Osiris is sticking to his solar subclass origins, and is actually wielding a Dawnblade. It's odd because he's always referenced as a Sunsinger. It's not clear what the difference between a Dawnblade and a Sunsinger is, if at all. Again, I presume there is a big difference because whilst you're using the same kind of light, different powers, different super, etc. So yeah, we'll see. Also some very big points worth noting. Looks like those old exotics that are returning, Telesto and Jade Rabbit, have been confirmed. We see them both in the trailer here. And it also looks like there's a brand new Coldheart, something with a solar effect this time. And it looks very different. The styling and the model is pretty similar, but it looks almost as though it's got this kind of ancient Egyptian theme to it that is also melded with all that Vex tech. It does really feel like it's fitting the expansion and all of its kind of theming. So, yeah, that's really good. Aside from anything else, we also have a release date, the 5th of December, which is what we had speculated before thanks to the releases of things such as, say, the Coldheart trailer, which talked about how the Coldheart would be available via a quest by the time that the 4th of December rolled around, and we assumed that that would mean the DLC would drop on a date very close to them. So, yeah, it would appear that we're going to be getting this at the date we expected. But more importantly than all of that, we got something which is teasing the second DLC. We don't know who the character is on this particular piece of art that shows ahead of the trailer. We don't know much about this at all. But we do know this. It's going to be revolving around the War Mines. So, yeah, we have a ton of new information here. The other note, of course, is regarding the story, which is apparently that hordes of Vex from both the past and the future have come together to try and crush us here in the present. And so we're going to be trying to stop a very dark future from coming to us at this exact moment. Osiris, it would appear, is the one who has foreseen this, and he has been working tirelessly to stop it. Osiris has a lot of connections to the deeper lore of Destiny. His entire search was really all about making sure that he could stop the darkness. It's part of the reason why he was exiled, is because his obsessions drew him too close to the darkness, and that brought him into conflict with the Speaker. So, yeah, we have a ton of information now, and this is amazing too, because this is only about, what, 36 days away? Lots and lots of cool stuff. Seriously, there's so much that I want to talk about on this, but expect an Osiris video very soon, either tomorrow or the day after. I'm going to be working on that the minute that this is uploaded. My apologies that this is shorter than you guys normally expect. Don't worry though, the typical lore stuff that I'm working on is most certainly not going to stop. I'm expecting soon that we'll get more information about this when the live streams from Bungie come out about Curse of Osiris, so yeah, really cool stuff. I am definitely looking forward to all of this. Anyway, I will catch you guys very soon, thank you very much for watching. And if you did enjoy this video or found it informative, then please do go ahead and leave a like. Also, if you want me to talk about anything more specifically regarding Osiris and the lore, please do go ahead and leave a comment down below. If you want more Destiny content and do want to catch that Osiris lore video later, then please do feel free to subscribe. You can also hit the bell next to subscribe to turn on email notifications. But of course, all that being said, your viewership is quite enough for me. And in the meantime, my name is Bife. Prodacia ad Astra. I'll see you, Starside.